know, Red Sea Diving Safaris uses this term eco-diving adventures. And, you know, these days it's a good, it's a catchy name, isn't it? Eco-diving, you get the idea straight away. But I read it as all being very close to nature. It just sort of comes from this diving system of villages, this whole safari style, being at one with nature. It's people like Hossam and Red Sea Diving Safaris, this whole group that are setting the high standards. And he sort of started with his colleagues this whole safari style that is close to nature. Just this morning I went over here on the north house reef, and there's that thing about house reef, isn't there? You think, oh, house reef. And most house reefs I've seen, they look like a house reef. It looks like the kind of place where people learn to dive and have a checkout dive and get organized. But this house reef, guys, it's just absolutely beautiful. This unlimited diving routine that works here, where you can go dive this beautiful reef north or south anytime you like. Some people get dropped off by boat and picked up by boat, some people out by boat, swim back or reverse. It's an easy feel. Down at Wadi Lucmi, the Fury Shoals are a bit further. It's a boat ride, so you go by boat, so it's a slightly different feel to it. I really enjoyed Fury Shoals. Fabulous, remote feel, untouched. It's pristine, it's beautiful, it's well managed. The whole sense of setting a high standard for diving in a close to nature, eco-friendly way is being done here. And I think it's very clever. It's setting a high standard. And that seems to reflect quite obviously on the people that come here. You know, there's a real sense of not just going in, swimming around looking for sharks. You can do that as well. So that's me. I'm a very happy man on holiday Red Sea Diving Safaris.